Okay, so we have on our body, when our calf cramps, when it's super tight and tight calf, you can actually see the outline of your calf muscle. I use that a lot because as a runner and a rider, when my calf hurts, then it's like spasms and I can totally see the outline of the horse. Horse's pain line, there are in two areas. Number one, you can see here where my mouse is on that slide. That's also known as a pain line or holding line, okay? So that is when the whole flank is super, super, super tight. And the other line, you can't see it so good on this picture, it goes across the shoulder right here, okay? And that is the indicator of the cranial nerve 11. And that particular one is also in one of the books by Dr. Johanna Robson. She has right on the front page, she calls it the pain line. Very often mistakenly on the racing track, they call it the fit line, but it's definitely caused because of bad saddles. So let's talk about this pain line back here. Okay, you see that on a lot of horses who have saddles which are way too long and put super stress or pinching here, or saddles what are super, super tight on the spine. So when the spine gets pinched because the actual, let me see if I have a slide here from, there you go. If you have the saddle what has a close pin fit, here you see a close up from the horse's vertebrae. Here you see the nerves coming out, spinal processes. Here this muscle, it says multifidus. So if the bottom of the saddle, okay, the spacing from one panel to the other is not wide enough, it will hit the multifidus muscle and it will cause this pain line and the horse will hollow and hold with the flank. This one is the other reason why they get the pain line when the saddle is digging into the loins, because there is a lot of saddle schools, and believe it or not, even some veterinarians who believe the saddle has to be bridging, so when the horse's back comes up, the saddle fits properly. But everybody knows there's two types of riders who want, one rider wants a swinging back, up and down, and one rider wants a hollow, stiff, where only the lower legs work. They call them the leg movers, or like Dr. Heuschmann calls them, the leg movers versus the back movers. So a horse what swings his back will not swing the back if it's digging in the back. So the horse holds in the back and there is tremendous pain. And the reason why I can say that, because we have people like this, University of Zurich shows that many saddle put tremendous pain in the front, not in the middle, and a lot of in the back. So rather than like the skeleton, what you see canters nice and round, the horse will go hollow and there's massive pressure on the spinalis muscle and the horses will eventually get pain. So look at the signs first. You see them, the eyes, the ears, horse don't know how to lie. Okay, we know a lot about areas of other pain indicators, but the question was, what are stress lines or holding lines? So you see them very common right here on the side, on the flank, or across the shoulder right there. Hunter bum, now there is a proper term, and the best way, my recommendation is you should Google it. And here, this horse, that is classified as a hunter term. If you want the exact way it's announced, what a hunter bum is, here you can see a lot of deformity. You can see here the holding line again, another stress line, another stress line. Okay, so this horse has a lot of saddle damage, other damages like badly ridden, fallen over the, out of, locked in the trailer, stuck in the racing gate. I mean, there's multiple things, but what we look in the books and when they talk about hunter bum, like you see here, is showing the indication that you see this line. The proper way, the proper terms, the proper names, you find if you wanted the veterinarian language, you need to look it under Google. But these are the indicators, and most of the time, it starts off, you don't see it, but man, is there a lot of heat in the back. Okay, so that's what's classified as the hunter bump.